Hi, and welcome back to Tie TV. I'm Niklaus Bauer, and today we are going to tie a hollow-style bucktail deceiver on tube, and we're going to tie it a little bit more hollow-style. A lot of bucktail, less flushable, some nice saddle hackles, and a fly that's not so bulky, not so visible in the water with all the flushable, more of a little bit more discreet pattern that has worked really well for me. The fly is pushing a lot of water, and it's fairly simple to tie if you're used to tying with bucktails, and it's not an advanced fly at all, but it's fun to tie, a little bit time consuming, but it's an awesome fly to fish with, and it really fishes well. So let's continue, or let's start. The first thing we do is we use a tube. This is a Eumer tube, and it's in size XL. It's hard, so when you pull the thread to raise the bucktail, it doesn't make the tube shrink together. So if you just use a normal tube that's much more softer for salmon fishing, you will have a tendency to pull the tube together, and you will have a hard time actually getting it from the tube needle. So go for these hard tubes. It's much better. So we just push it up like that. As you can see, we're gonna have a tail here that we're gonna put some feathers around, and also some little bit wider flashable magnum here. And so we start this maybe 2 centimeters into the tube like that. So the first thing we do is we take some glue. I prefer this glue with a pencil here. We make one nice turn like that. And then we take your favorite thread. I use this Textream power thread. I think it's a very nice nice thread to use, and it's also very strong. So you just put the thread into the wet glue and wrap it a few times so you have a good steady point here. And I usually put some more glue over here because I want to have a fly that's really durable and should be able to catch a lot of fish. So there we go, we have a good position here, we have a good strong start. So now we're gonna go for a nice bucktail tail here. We go for this one here. I want to have some from the bottom of the tail here, where you have a little bit more air into the fibers. Take a fairly big bunch, because I'm gonna take all these small and short fibers off like that. So I just want a little bit longer ones. This bucktail bunch here, we're not gonna reverse, we're just gonna tie it straight as a tail. You put it, you make sure the glue is dry, and just make a nice even spread around it like this. You just go 1, 2, 3, and then you pull it like that, and you will have the bucktail spread out nice and evenly like that. Just work like 8 or 10 times through here, so you have a good strong position for the thread. And you just take one of your hair clamps and put it over the bunch that's in the back, and we just cut the existing material off here. It's very important to have a sharp scissor here. Oops. Almost cutting the thread like that, it's nice. Make a few turns like that, and there we have the first tail like that. Put some glue on again, all around that. And then I want to have some wider flushable in the tail here that really makes the fly move well, and I don't want to have this thin flushable in the tail because they just tangle in the stinger hook. So I want to have it a little bit wider flushable. I prefer these Magnum flushable. This is the color Opal, and just take like around 10 fibers like that. This is the full length of them, and I want to have them tied like 50% in like that. So what you want to do is you want to taper the ends like this, pull it all the way like that. You make sure that the ends are a little bit tapered, So we don't have a fly that looks like it's just store-bought or just like a straight chopped-off tail. So now they're a little bit tapered like that, and I take this bunch into two. Put one of those in front of you. The other one you try to nice and evenly spread out here on the top of this. So we tie it 50% back and 50% in the front. We'll make one turn over there like that. Try to spread these over. Make a few turns with the bobbin. And then we just fold these guys back here. Try to spread them on a 180 degree angle from this side to this side here. And they're pretty long now. So we do exactly the same thing on the belly of the fly. Just turn it around like that. We tie them in the center like that. Try to spread them around, all around the tube like that. And then we just fold these guys back again. It's important to always, when you're tying with flashable, that you fold it. Because if you don't fold it, you don't have, it's gonna be very easy for the fish when the fly gets really worn out. The flashable and the glue is gonna just go apart. And if you haven't folded, you're just gonna have like all the flashable is just gonna come off the fly. So it's important that always fold flashable when you use it. So there we go. Now we have a nice evenly spread, pretty long tail. And then I wanna have some hackles or some saddle hackles onto this to make a little bit more color and also a nice movement to the fly. These are just your normal Hebert saddles. It's dry fly saddles actually, but I like them because they're so soft, so they really really move well. So we're just gonna pick out like 8 or 10 feathers here and a little bit different length. I go 6, go for another, it's a little bit fatter one. Yeah, we have one more that's a little bit heavier. Put some glue on again, just to secure the flashable. And also, when you tie in the feathers, if you tie them into a little bit wetter glue, they will last and hold much better on the fly. Let's take all the stuff off. We place one on this side. Just tie it like that. On the other side. Try to make them flat and nice on the sides. And then we take these little bit longer ones here and spread them pretty equally around the whole collar here. If you think feathers are a little bit too expensive, you can definitely use ostrich hurls. You will not have really the same length, but you will definitely have a fly that will move very well. But these feathers are actually very strong, so you don't need to be afraid that they will disappear after one or two fish, that they really stick to the fly actually. And the two feathers I have on the belly, I put them a little bit shorter, just so they don't tangle too much. There we go. So now we have a nice tail with feathers all around. Just cut these feather stems off here. Put some thread over here. And actually give a good pull here right in the center where the bucktail is, because it will lift the bucktail a little bit more again. And then glue. The pike fly tire's best friend, super glue. Now you can put the hair clamp over again here if you want to. And then This is definitely not necessary. You can just leave it like that and then just start with the next bucktail bunch here or collar here. But I like to have some dubbing on here because it looks much, much better. This is just some SLF Prism. This is a UV pearl. So we just put some on there. Not too much, just to cover the thread. It doesn't matter if the glue is wet, this will only make the dubbing stick better. And we go like 1 centimeter ahead here. Looks good. Now we take the second bucktail collar here, and I'm gonna go that all white. But this one we're gonna tie forward and hollow tie it, so we're gonna reverse it. So you want to have a bucktail with a little bit more air in it, once again, and some nice length to it. So once again, we go from the lower part of the tail, hold it between your fingers, pull out all the small fibers out like that. There we go. And we're gonna tie this forward. You wanna try to spread this nice and even around the tube here. So that's what you're gonna do, just like you did the first time. Make a few turns and then just pull it like that. You walk through the collar here with the thread. Like 8 to 10 times. You take a look so you see that the collar has the same amount of hair all around, like you have here. Make a few extra turns. We take another clamp here, and then we cut all the existing material off here. We don't need that, because you want to have a fly that is light, easy to cast. Don't overdress it. It's really the less is more factor here. So there we go. And then you just take a tube from a pen and just push it over like this. Nice. Don't push it too hard. Just walk it over a little bit like that. And then you take the thread, don't go like this, pull it towards your to the right, and then tie it in front here. This is gonna create a support for the collar, because if you don't do this, the collar is just gonna stand straight up like that, and all the fibers and all the flashable we're gonna put here is just gonna go between it. So you want to have the bucktail leaning backwards in a 45 degree angle. So that's what you need to do here. You need to build a support for the collar. Something like that. So I put the hair clamp over again there. Glue on the thread here. Be careful here so you don't get the glue up into the bucktail, because then you're gonna have a bucktail that when you take this one off here, it's gonna lay flat back. And then I want to use thinner flashable now, because it really moves well, and I prefer this new flashable from Hedron here. This is a lateral scale, but it's a thin one, and it really shines in the water, and you don't really need super much of it. You just need, well, in Sweden we have a word called lagom. You don't have it in English, but it's a very good word. So you take maybe, I would say, 15 to 20 fibers like that. And once again, we taper them. Like that. So they look good. We take this bunch here and we divide it into two. Just like we did with the first one. And then we tie it in make sure that the glue is dry, and we tie it in, and I usually tie this 60% back and 40% in the front. And we tie it 160 degrees on the top here. Try to spread it nice around. Fold that back like this and put your thumb here, and it will spread out nice and even. Make a few turns, and we do the exactly the same thing on the belly of the fly. So 60% on the back. A few turns, spread it with your thumb, and have one fiber that's there we go. So there we go. And if you take this up now, you're gonna see that the flushable is nicely spread even around there. And we're ready for some glue, some dubbing, and then the third color. The third tie after the tail there. Some glue. Just like I said the last time, you don't need to do this here, but I like it, so that's why I'm doing it. I don't think the pike will reject the fly just because it doesn't have the dubbing in between here, but well, it's up to you. And that's the first color. You have a tail, first color. Now we're gonna do the second color. We're gonna mix this, so we're gonna have a mix of, as you can see here, we're gonna have a mix of fluo cerise or fuchsia, blue, and some white. And this is to give it this kind of a bait fish herring kind of look in the water. I don't know if you have seen so many herrings looking like this, but it has a very nice shimmer in the water. So we take a little bit smaller bunch. Just pull it, once again, pull the fibers out like that. Put it on the table. Go for some blue. This is fluorescent blue. Take the short fibers out like that again. You just want a little bit longer one. Put it on the table, on the bunch. And then we're gonna go for some white fibers here. See, we have some with nice length to it. There we go. And you put it on the same bunch there. And then you want to mix them together nice now, so they become a good mix. The first thing you can do is you can just kind of roll it together like this between your fingers. And then you hold it on the tips like this, or a few centimeters in from the tip. And you just take a comb and you just start combing them like this. What you do that is you, in a very easy and simple way, you mix these different colors together. You can fold them together a little bit. They need a little bit of help, but it's definitely the easiest way to mix them together, in my opinion at least. So now we got a good mess on the table and a good mix in your hand. What we're gonna do is we're gonna do exactly like we did the last time. We can stack it at the table a little bit so we get all the ends fairly similar like that. And then we're gonna tie it forward. Good spread, just like last time. Try to get it evenly around the tube. You see that you get the material towards you here. A few turns and then you pull it. And if you have a thread that's fairly strong, you can pull pretty much here if you want to. Trying to get some thread in between here, so you have a good strong color. There you go. Gonna take a look. Well, it was a little bit weak on the bottom there. Or on the stomach, I'll just put a few white ones there. we get this hair out of the way here. Get this one too out of the way. And then we take all the short existing or material that's not supposed to be here off. There we go. Now we have this nice mix of color here. So once again, we're gonna take the tube from the pen here, and we're just carefully gonna go over again. We'll go back like that. Hold it with your left hand. Take the bobbin and the thread, go straight to your right, and then make a nice supporting, like a slope. Sometimes it needs to make a lot of turns, and sometimes it's goes pretty easy. So there we go, it's almost like I want it, maybe just a few turns more. I think we're kind of home there. So now we got this nice tail here that's kind of a little bit more, it's not so see-through, it's a little bit more consistent in color. And then you have these nice bucktail that really spreads out. They're gonna move a lot of water, but they're also gonna be fairly see-through, so it's not gonna be so heavy fly. We're gonna put some flashable around that, but first some glue again. There we go. Once again, we're gonna go for some of this thinner lateral scale, but we're not gonna go for as many, the same amount as last time, just maybe half of that. And I'm gonna go for some flashable mirage, but we have this in purple here. Looks pretty cool when you mix it. So we take a lot, maybe 10, 12 fibers of that. We just mix them together. And the easiest way to mix flushable, in my opinion, is just to use a comb like this and just comb them together. But you just comb them and you move it between your thumb and your finger on the other hand. And you get a good mix of those. You make sure that they are a little bit tapered, so they don't look chopped off like that. And once again, we divide that bunch here into two. Take the first one, make sure that the glue is not too wet, and we tie it in 60% to the tail and 40% in the front, and 180 degrees around the fly like this, or at least we're supposed to do it like that. Make a few turns, fold this back, put your thumb to it, and make a few turns again. And we do the exactly the same thing on the belly. There we go. Then we had some fibers standing right up. So we do it like that. Spread it around a little bit. Like that. Make a few turns. Fold this over. Make a good spread with your thumb. Try to get it nice and evenly spread around there. I think I managed this time. Yeah. And now we got this second collar here all done. You have this, it's not gonna be so easy to see here because these colors on these mirage is not so, they're not so strong, but when you have them in the water, it's really gonna turn to purple. It looks really awesome. So put that on again. There we go. Make a few turns up there. And we go for some dubbing again. So we just push this up here. It's good when you sit in a warm studio because your fingers get all sweaty. So it's really easy to dub. And just pull that tight. Like that. Just a little bit more. Pull it up like that. Actually, we can put some red here if you want. It might be visible. It it will look like gills on the fish. So we'll put some of those. There we go. We also have some gills there, even if the fish won't see it. I know they're there. So the last color, we're gonna do almost the same mix, but we're gonna put some olive in into it, so it becomes more of a little bit darker head. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go for some olive. I think I'm gonna go a little bit darker this time here. So a little bit more olive. Maybe a little bit more. And when you play around with bucktail and different colors, you can really make cool mixes of different colors. So don't be afraid to kind of like blend pink and chartreuse and stuff like that, because the mixture of those can be really, really nice. Some white here. Not so much white though. Really take the short ones off here. I just want a few of the white ones, not a lot at all. And some nice long blue fibers. Also just take the long ones here. Put that on the same bunch there. And some really strong color here. There we go. All in the same pile. Just doing like we did last time, trying to fold them together like this. There we go. And then we start combing them a little bit here. So we comb them together. There's always a few fibers gonna disappear here, but there's a lot on a bucktail, so it's not a problem. And then we have a pretty nice mixture. There we go. You can just stack it on the table, so it becomes a little bit more even. And then we tie this just like we did with the last bunch. Try to spread it around nice and even. Try to see that you meet the material here when you make the thread turn around. So one, two, and then we pull it like that. And then you work through this again here, just like the previous ones. There we go. Make sure it's nice and strong. You go for the babyless hair clamp here again. Cut all the material off here. It's not gonna be there. There we go. Make a few turns like that. Take off the clamp. And nice and gentle, push it over like that. Once again, take the bobbin and the thread forward, and we're gonna make the supporting collar again here. Something like that. Ooh, too fast. Oops. What we're not gonna do is we're not gonna have any flashable onto this one, but I would like to have a little bit darker top to it here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put some glue here just to secure everything, and I'm just gonna take some nice really long olive ones here, the longest I can find here. We'll just take a whole bunch and just use the longest ones we can find. I'll hold it right out on the tip, so I just get the really long fibers. There we go. And then we put it on the top here. And just tie it pretty nice and heavy here in front of it. There we go. Make a few turns, so really it's really strong. And we cut the fibers off here in front. There we go. Put some thread onto that. And as usual, glue. There we go. And because it's a Dyneema thread, you can just cut it off like that, and or actually you can do this with whatever thread you have and just push it up in the glue and it's kind of done. So there we go, we have a nice hollow tie, big, bulky, but still fairly easy to cast, pike fly. So what we're gonna do now is glue some eyes on this and it will really pop. So what I do, I use the 11 millimeter epoxy eyes. Once again, how we glue these is that I don't want to have a lot of glue around them, because it makes the head really bulky. And if you go for good quality eyes, no China crap, they will really stick like this and they won't destroy even if you had a lot of fish. So then you can just put glue in the two gaps here. So we take these off here, we put one this side here. I like to have them positioned pretty high up on the head so that it doesn't look like they're just in front of the head. You're also going to have a fly that becomes much, much more durable when you get the epoxy down here. So now we're gonna mix some epoxy. I like to put some of this loon fly tying powder into the epoxy. There's actually two good things with it. The first is that it makes a little bit more of a shiny head when it comes into the sun, and also it makes the epoxy not so it makes the epoxy a little bit easier to work with. If you put a lot of epoxy in between the eyes, it doesn't drip as easy as it does if you just have it normally mixed like that. So put some powder in here. Take my cool dubbing needle here. Just mix it together. Something like that. And then what we want to do is we want to fill this gap between here. So you just put some epoxy nice here. You can actually take your dubbing needle and poke it down a little bit in the bucktail, so it really stays, really get the epoxy down there. I like that. Maybe a little bit more top here. We just put it into the drying wheel here. And in 3 minutes we have a fly that's ready. So it's been on the drying wheel here now for a few minutes. The easiest way is just to feel the paper where you mix the epoxy on when it's done. And there we go, take that off there. We have a pretty cool hollow tie pike fly that's really gonna move a lot of water and definitely gonna catch some nice pike. I fished these flies with a with a rig that's called a Bauer pike rig, because you just don't want to have one small hook here. You want to have a hook that's situated pretty far back. So what we have is we have this is a partridge, a 4-0, and then we have a titanium wire to a stinger, and then also we have a rattle chamber here that rattles, and that also makes one more point of interest for the fish. So just push this through here, all the way like that, pull it through, and you can see that you will have one hook situated here on the fly and one all the way in the back. So if the fish is just nibbling on the tail, they will get stuck on the stinger, or otherwise when they go for the throat, they will go on the big hook like that. So that's a good setup in my opinion. And if you hit this with some UV light here, you will see that all the fluorescent colors really glows. Not too bad. So guys and girls, thanks for watching, and until next time, let's go fishing.